some of you have seen on the video I did, the wind got this plastic and had folded it, and this one was one of the ones I thought was better sealed. My wife came out here and we went around two-thirds of this, three-quarters of this plastic garden. I'm out of breath because we've been doing this for a while. We dug a little trench like and then put the soil around the edge as good as possible. Not really as good as possible, but you know, enough to get by. And put a few on the bigger holes, some soil on the bigger holes, so the air doesn't catch it up underneath. And it's just, like I said, it's a lot of work. Once it's done, I mean, this is still not even done, completely done right. This was done when we got the plastic last spring. Before it started getting too warm, we rolled it out when it was windy out here. We cut it while it was windy out here. We never buried it while it was windy out here. We buried some of the edges and put some stones around it, boards mainly. I don't know if you heard after what I just said, but anyway, we did that all here because it's so windy out here now. It's even windy. It's windy out here about 80% of the time, and that's 12 months out of the year. It's just cooler wind in the wintertime and a warmer wind in the summertime. So we've been trying to do this the best we can, and I see a part over there. I'm going to have to try to use a shovel by myself right now and put some soil on top of that, some dirt on top of that. Then I'm going to use a rake to pull some of the leaves to get some pecans over there from the trees, because it's leaves like this all over the place. All the trees from the constant aluminum that's coming out of the atmosphere, which most people can sit there with like, whoa, it ain't coming out. Yeah, it is. You know, the more you say anything, the more stupid you look. So anyway, it's fall, the leaves are turning, but I showed you this back in the summer too. South side of the tree, north side, okay. That tree is facing me. That tree is facing west, I'm facing east. See all that? It's on that tree. It's on the tree on the far end over there. It's on that, look at that tree, how bad that one is. The leaves on that tree already fall completely. Even the pecan tree's got this on here. Like I said, this is what's going on right in front of you. And because you're so stupid and you sit on your thumb all the time, you're not saying anything. The trees are dying. Maybe give this another 5 years. If it goes that far, this tree will be putting no leaves up hardly. But you know what? They want something to happen pretty soon anyway. So all I can tell you is start speaking up. Getting with your, you know, you're better off being with other people that are like-minded, because the mafia in the Washington D.C. area, they really don't give a shit about you, although they'll give you lip service, and they laugh their asses off because you keep believing it, you keep falling for it, you keep doing that really, really stupid ass thing, voting. Oh yeah, I can vote them out of office. Oh yeah, I can vote them out of office. For 200 years, you've been voting them out of office. How's that working for you, huh? Yeah. God. People better start waiting. When people wake up, they're going to get really pissed off. And that's what they're afraid of. That's why they want to try to disarm you as much as they can. Obama's going to go for that again, yet again. He's got all these refugees coming over here that's being put in secret now, because all the governors are saying, no, we don't want them. So he's putting them in secret in different locations. You want to talk about a Muslim, what do you call that? What's those groups? Those groups that come out of nowhere, you know, those whatever they are, mole group, whatever. But that's what he's doing right now. He's putting them all over the United States. And when you're fighting for your very life, maybe you'll wake up and say, oh, I should have thought about that before, duh. If there was a thing called a stupid stick, I would have it and I'd knock the shit out of the majority of you. The rest of you know. So we've got some vegetables. We've got enough to get us through about a year. Got enough to plant for another 100 plus years, but you know, that's neither here nor there. Let's see what happens. Let's see if we get to this next summer, how everything goes. Let me get a shovel and bury that edge over there. So, stay safe. don't do it for yourself. At least do it for your kids and your people that you care about. That's stupid, you know. At least do it for somebody else.